Ever since Charles Fritz coated the semiconductor selenium with a thin layer of gold to make the first solid-state photovoltaic cell way back in 1879, science pods all over the world have been developing the process to make it more efficient, more practical, and less expensive. Modern panels are about 20 times as efficient as those first prototypes, and recent mass production, mostly in China, has brought prices down to extremely competitive levels. Solar PV panels are perfect for rooftops and ground-mounted arrays, and of course, they're already playing a major role in the transition away from fossil fuels towards more sustainable electricity grids. But there are millions of surfaces in our modern world that are not quite so conveniently flat, and many of them also get exposed to sunlight every day. No doubt you've heard the statistics about the mind-blowing amount of sunlight that reaches our planet, but it doesn't hurt to remind ourselves every now and then that the amount of power from the sun striking the Earth in one single hour is more than the entire world consumes in a whole year. Unsurprisingly then, a whole sphere of research has grown up to find ways to build solar PV technology into thinner and more flexible materials that might be able to take advantage of all those currently underutilized and awkwardly shaped surfaces. Thin film cells have been used in things like solar-powered calculators since the 1970s. Nowadays, we're starting to see flexible panels appearing on some electric vehicles and in a few very sophisticated building integrated systems. But it's still far from mainstream, and that's a shame, because if someone can really nail it, then flexible thin film photovoltaics could be mopping up the sun's energy all over the place, providing immediate localized energy to drive our modern technologies with zero carbon emissions at the point of use. Well, now a UK company called Powerroll reckon they've come up with a revolutionary new way of fabricating highly efficient, flexible photovoltaic rolls that could just fit that bill perfectly. Hello, and welcome to Just Have a Think. Powerroll are a specialist materials architecture company based in County Durham up in the northeast of England. They've teamed up with a physicist and inventor by the name of John Topping, who has extensive expertise in the production of vacuum-coated materials used in the food packaging industry. You know, things like those snack wrappers with metallized internal surfaces. Apparently, John had a bit of an epiphany moment a few years back when he realized that it might be possible to combine those very inexpensive roll-to-roll vacuum coating systems with the latest microscale printing and embossing technologies to come up with a process that could manufacture solar photovoltaic films at the same speed and with the same mass production economies of scale as food wrappers. I caught up with the chief executive of Powerroll, Neil Spann, via Zoom a few weeks ago to learn more about how the process works. A typical solar panel is made up of a transparent conductive oxide, or TCO, layer on top of a semiconductor, typically silicon. The top section of silicon is infused or doped with another element like phosphorus, and the bottom section is doped with something like boron. When photons hit the silicon layer, they knock electrons free, and for reasons that are outside the scope of this video, the two doped materials act like electrodes on either side of a battery and facilitate the movement of those electrons out of the photovoltaic sandwich and into an electrical circuit. We looked at exactly what causes this to happen in an earlier video about perovskite solar panels, so if you're keen to get the detail, then you can click the link up there to jump back to that one. The Powerroll system effectively turns that sandwich arrangement on its side. The starting point is a pretty standard polymer substrate, like PET, into which tiny microstructures are embossed, creating V-shaped channels or grooves in the material that are no more than 1 or 2 microns thick. That's about 1/50th of the width of an average human hair and about 1/5 the width of a human blood cell. A 10 by 10 centimeter square can contain 17,000 of these channels running parallel to each other across the width of the panel. A vacuum coating system applies the electrodes and electron transfer layers equivalent to the horizontal layers in a standard silicon cell, effectively creating negative and positive electrodes. Powerroll has developed a unique proprietary technique to ensure an even coating and to make sure that the two materials can't come into contact with each other at the base of the groove, because that'd cause a short circuit which you don't want. Then a solar absorbing ink is printed into the middle part of the groove. That arrangement does away with the need for the expensive TCO layer. Light just comes straight in, hits the ink, and contacts with the electrodes on either side. There's a single volt of potential difference in each groove based on the current solar ink that Powerroll is using, and the architecture of the construction means the grooves are physically connected together in series, in other words, negative to positive. You may remember from school physics lessons that connecting batteries in series adds up their voltages. That means a piece of material that's only 10 centimeters wide can have a potential difference across it of 17,000 volts. Now, sticking 17,000 volt materials onto the sides of bus shelters and letterboxes is probably not a great idea, so the next step in the Powerroll process is to physically separate the channels into microscopic modules, or cascades as they're known. It's a patented technique that Powerroll called delineation. The grooves can be split into as many or as few cascades as necessary, depending on the voltage required by a given application. So for example, by splitting 17,000 grooves into 340 cascades, each cascade will have a potential difference of 50 volts, which sounds a bit less fatal, doesn't it? The separated cascades are then connected back up in parallel, which keeps the voltage the same, but increases the current. That means the size of the current is derived not just from the length of each conductive groove, but also by how many parallel connected cascades there are on the panel. Another crucial proprietary element of the process is a technology that ensures extreme accuracy in the separation between the cascades, again eliminating the risk of unwanted cross-communication. The panel gets a final protection coating, and that's it, done. All that's required now is for wires to be attached to either side to produce an electrical circuit, and of course some photons from sunshine to start knocking those electrons out of their comfort zone. One of the beauties of this configuration is that if one cascade is in shade or gets damaged, it doesn't affect the other cascades either side of it. They just keep on generating regardless. You could literally nail one of these things to a wooden post and it'd keep working. Although that's obviously not going to be the recommended installation procedure. Instead, a highly adhesive backing film will be supplied to do the job. According to the folks at Powerroll, their process is completely unique and extremely inexpensive because it's based on the smart combination of already existing technologies. The embossing technology is the same as the systems used to create the little holograms on your credit and debit cards. The vacuum coating technology comes straight from the food packaging industry, and the ink printing technology is well established in many different sectors. Working out how to combine all three together effectively has taken a great deal of development work though, and the Powerroll process is now patented in 70 countries around the world. Full-scale production films will be produced in widths of either 30, 50 or 100 centimetres, and a typical panel will be up to 10 metres in length. The business model here is not to directly compete with existing rigid solar PV panels. The efficiency of the Powerroll film is currently about 11%, with a development path towards 16%. Now, the main goal is really to drive down the cost of production and provide a solution that can easily be replicated anywhere in the world, energizing previously inaccessible surfaces to produce very useful local electricity. Powerroll have been working with test houses in the US and Europe, including the American National Renewable Energy Lab, or NREL. Test data suggests that a roll of film light enough for an average person to carry in their arms would have a generating capacity of 20 kilowatts. That opens up all sorts of applications that are only really limited by the imagination, not just in industrialized countries, but in developing nations as well. In remote off-grid locations, they could become a very inexpensive and portable carbon-free replacement for diesel generators and kerosene lamps. They'd also be a perfect fit for tensile structures like the roof of the Millennium Dome in London, for example, or perhaps more usefully, on tents in refugee camps that are sadly becoming more and more commonplace as climate change and regional conflicts continue to flare up around the world. The production of the film itself does, of course, have a carbon footprint, mainly in the PET material used as the substrate. But there are no high temperatures involved in any of the steps, and overall, it's a high-speed, low-energy process. Compared to traditional rigid silicon PV panels, it only has about 1/20th of the carbon impact. The levelized cost of electricity has also been analyzed and assessed to be 45% lower than rigid PV panels, which translates into about half the payback time of a traditional solar PV installation. The next step for Powerroll is full testing to achieve global industry accreditation. One of the results of that testing will be a certified operational lifetime, but Powerroll's own fairly rigorous internal tests have shown this to be a very robust product with a projected lifetime of between 10 and 15 years. Powerroll will maintain a production and research and development facility here in the UK and then license the technology to manufacturing partners around the world. Partnering with companies in other territories is a smart strategic move. It accelerates the speed of global distribution and utilizes local expertise to reach otherwise inaccessible markets. It also affords some protection against patent infringement and counterfeiting, which will almost certainly become a challenge as the technology gains in popularity. The UK pilot plant will be finalised in 2021, with larger volume production and commercial licensing commencing in 2022, and mass production in multiple geographic locations during 2023. As we transition to a more sustainable future, we'll need every viable renewable technology available over the coming decades. Decentralized distributed power sources like this one will play a big role in that effort, and they have huge potential to transform lives all over the world. As always, if you've got experience in this industry or views about this technology one way or the other, then why not jump down to the comment section below and leave your thoughts there. That's it for this week though. I'm having a snoop around the COP26 climate conference up in Glasgow for the next few days, so there'll be no video next weekend, but I'll be back with another dive into the world of climate change and sustainable energy on Sunday the 14th of November. In the meantime, thanks for watching, and I must just give a quick shout out to the folks who've just started supporting the channel over at Patreon with pledges of $10 or more a month. They are Catherine Rogers, Greg Scuder, Mitch Rawlick, B. Main, William Ead, Dan Furrow Daniels, Ross Johnson, Josh Noon, Quentin Webb, Larry McCulloch, Owen Gintis, David Murphy, Simon Knapp, Alistair McLaughlin, Louise Acresti, Terence Curran, Murray McLaughlin, Richard Innes, Christopher Bissonette, Craig Anderson, Paul Cullen, George Miranda, Eric Sununas, Dan Schaefer, James Sternlight, Ian Nash, Paul Doucette, Michelle Deathmers, and Tony Troughton-Smith. And of course, a big thank you to everyone else who's joined since last time too. You can join them by visiting www.patreon.com/justhaveathink. And you can hugely support the channel completely for free by hitting that subscribe button, which you can do very easily by clicking down there or on that icon there. So thanks again for watching. Have a great couple of weeks. And remember to just have a think. See you soon.